what exactly happens is somebody having risk factors like family, there is a heart disease is there, diabetes is there, high blood pressure is there. These are genetically coming to our body through our parents or forefathers, which we can do something. We may not totally cure all those things, but definitely if you detect them before, we can definitely solve the problem. Next thing is smoking. Smoking is totally in our control, and smoking young people heart attack means mostly it is smoking. So third important thing is the fast foods. You see people consuming highly saturated fats, consuming a lot of meat and milk products, sweets, all these things. So, and lack of exercise. The international WHO recommend 3 weeks session of 45 minutes minimum exercise, and none of us are doing this. That's why what happens is the LDL cholesterol, which is the bad cholesterol, accumulates. The LDL cholesterol from the lumen of the artery goes into the wall by a process. So this LDL cholesterol is covered by one cover called fibrous cap. What happens is this cholesterol builds up in the artery wall for some time, and when you are exposed to some stress like an infection, or when you expose it to some stress of a family emotional stress or anything else like that, will precipitate what is called a plaque rupture. That means the cholesterol which is there in the artery wall comes back to the lumen by rupture of this cap. So once it comes back, the plaque, the cholesterol burden, then it flares up what is called a thrombus. So it's like a fire. The thrombus comes into the lumen, it totally blocks the artery. This is what is called the heart attack. So heart attack means the thrombus clot comes onto the plaque, cholesterol plaque. So it comes suddenly and blocks the artery. Whatever area that artery is supplying in the heart gets dead. Within 1 hour, if you don't treat, and the damage is permanent. So immediate after the heart attack, what happens, the heart becomes very irritable. So it goes on beating at 200, 300, 400 heart rate. This is called ventricular fibrillation.